Hello, I'm Marshall from Lead Extension. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to build a new WooCommerce store from scratch. Before we begin, let's have a quick overview of what we're going to do in this video. First, I'm going to show you how to create a new database using PHP MyAdmin. Then we're going to download the WordPress package and upload it to the server. Next, we're going to edit the configuration sample file and add our database information. After that, we're going to run the installation script by accessing the URL in a web browser. When WordPress is installed, we're going to add the WooCommerce plugin. Once the store is set up, I'm going to show you the basic steps to add your products and configure your settings. That's all about it. Stay tuned. If you're about to move your store from your current platform to WooCommerce, check out our tutorial video. Lead Extension is a world-leading shopping cart migration provider. We not only help migrate your products, customers, and orders, but also provide additional options such as customer password migration or creating 301 redirects. Now let's get into how to build a WooCommerce store. Basically, WooCommerce is a plugin that is added to WordPress websites. So in order to build a WooCommerce store, you have to install WordPress first. Don't worry if you're a beginner. This video is made for those of you who have little to no experience with e-commerce platforms. Just follow the steps in the video and there should be no problem. Alright, let's begin. I'm gonna install WordPress manually using PHP MyAdmin. If you're using a hosting service from web hosting companies such as Bluehost or SiteGround, you might already have a WordPress database set up for you. I've written an article showing how to install WordPress with these hosting services in detail. Make sure to check it out. I'll put the link in the description. Okay, to begin, launch PHP MyAdmin. Go to the Databases tab to create one. In some cases, your hosting provider will require a name that begins with your username and an underscore, so make sure to check their requirements. Now choose the best collation for your language and encoding. Here, I highly recommend that you choose something that begins with UTF-8. If you can't find your language, just go for this one. Okay, now click on create and you're ready for the next step. After creating a database, let's download WordPress and install it on our server. First, go to wordpress.org. Click on get WordPress and then download it. You should receive a zip file like this. To install it on our server, I'm gonna use an FTP client. One of the most common ones to use is FileZilla client. I'll put the link in the description. Make sure to follow the link and download it. To connect to your server, go to File and then Site Manager. Now select the protocol and enter your host. Enter the username and password to the server. If you don't know the password, contact your hosting provider. Navigate to the root directory. This may vary across hosting providers and operating systems. Contact your provider if you're not sure about it. You can choose to install WordPress right in the root directory or a subdirectory. There are several ways to upload the files. Normally, I would upload the zip file and then extract it later because it takes much less time to do so. Navigate to the WordPress zip file that you downloaded and then upload it. Now we will have to extract the file on the server. Because FileZilla doesn't have an option to extract the file, we will have to use another software called PuTTY. I also put the link to it in the description. So you launch PuTTY and then connect to the host. Enter your username and password to access your server. The password won't be displayed, so make sure to type it correctly. Now navigate to the directory where you uploaded the WordPress zip file by using the cd command. To make things easier, just copy the address from FileZilla and then right-click on the cd command to paste it. Now we're in the right directory. To unzip the file, use the unzip command. Press tab and the file name will automatically be completed. After the file is unzipped, exit and go back to FileZilla. Refresh and you will see a WordPress directory that has just been created. Go to the directory and look for a PHP file named wp-config-sample. We're gonna have to edit the file in order to tell WordPress our database information. Now replace the database name here with your database name that you created in the first step.
we do the same to our username and password. Most of the time, the host name will be localhost, so you won't have to change this. But if it doesn't work, contact your hosting provider. After you're done filling in the information, save the file and close it. There will be a message saying file has changed. Click on the box here and click yes. Now rename the file to wp-config.php, meaning you will delete the sample. Okay, now WordPress should be ready for installation. To do that, launch a web browser and go to the directory that contains the WordPress files. And then add wp-admin/install.php. Now enter the information such as your site title, your username and password to log into your WordPress website. After that, click on Install WordPress and wait for a few seconds. There should be a message saying WordPress has been installed. Now you can log into your WordPress website using the username and password you just created. The next step is to install WooCommerce plugin to your WordPress page. To do that, go to wordpress.org/plugin/WooCommerce. Now let's upload the plugin to the server. In the remote site area, go to WordPress and then plugins. That's where we're gonna upload the zip file. Now go back to PuTTY to unzip the file using the same commands we did the last time. Right click to paste. Refresh and a WooCommerce directory should appear right here. Now go back to your WordPress admin to activate WooCommerce. It will offer a setup wizard that will help you make an easy start. Click on Yes Please to begin. Here you will fill in the basic information to configure your store. Just follow the steps and everything should be okay. Here WooCommerce offers a few marketing tools. You can always activate or deactivate them later. And that's it. WooCommerce setup is completed. Now let's add a product. There are three options. If you're running a store on another platform, you can export CSV files and import them to your new store, or you can migrate them using our automated migration service at leadextension.com. For now, let's go for the first option. Here you can add your product information such as name, description, category, and so on. Here you add an image for your product. This will be the main image displayed on the shop page. You can add several more in the product gallery section. Adding product data is the most important part. Make sure to go through every section and fill in the required information. The final step is to hit publish. Now you can go customize your store appearance. If you're not used to designing stuff, I recommend you hire a professional designer or search for premium WooCommerce themes. Before your store is ready for customers, you need further configurations. Go to WooCommerce and click on Settings. There are several tabs. Make sure to go through each one and provide detailed information.
That's it, guys. WooCommerce may not be the most user-friendly platform for beginners, but if you invest your time and effort in creating a store, it can be a really powerful tool. If you're currently selling on another platform, we have an all-in-one migration service that will cover everything, including building a new store and migrating all data for you. Again, I'll put the link in the description. Make sure to go check it out. Let me know in the comments what you think is the most suitable hosting provider for WordPress websites. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more shopping cart comparison videos and tutorials. See you next time.